Sonata Blue, what it do? Aye, so in this episode of Hip Hop History, we got Mobb Deep crew versus CNN crew. First and foremost, R.I.P. the Prodigy, but him and Nore had an ongoing beef for years that really had nothing to do with music. A lot of stuff happened in the streets, but I'ma touch on one incident that went way left field and almost ended with dudes chilling in heaven with Jesus, teaching him Fortnite dances, teaching him how to do the justice. Aye, so boom. Havoc from Mobb Deep found out a dude from his hood called Tragedy was smashing his girl to smithereens, right? And you know dudes don't play about that poo-poo snatch. They be ready to do life in a box over that box. So Havoc met up with his homies, and him, Prodigy, and a few dudes from his block went to where Tragedy hung out at. That place just happened to be Capone from CNN's crib. So boom, they knock on Capone's door looking for Tragedy, and Tragedy ends up coming outside with Capone and Noriega. Now, according to Prodigy, when Tragedy came outside, Havoc confronted him. He was like, "Yo, I heard you was kangaroo fucking my bitch, stretching her coon out. I had it the perfect size, and now when I hit it, it's like throwing a hot dog in the hallway." Tragedy was acting all confused, like, "Nah, bro, he ain't know what Havoc was talking about." But Havoc wasn't trying to hear none of that, and he just punched Tragedy in the face. "Meek, hold that, nigga." So he hit Tragedy and, like, knocked the sonic rings out of him, and Tragedy dropped. But remember, this is what Prodigy said happened. This is all from Prodigy's point of view. So after Havoc dropped him, Tragedy started to get up, and somebody from Mobb Deep crew told Tragedy, "You better not hit him back."
Karate Joe warned Tragedy, "You better not hit him back." Had punched Tragedy again.
And I kind of believe this portion of the story, because them Mobb Deep niggas like 4 feet tall. Them niggas black leprechauns. So when Havoc punched them, he probably had to get a running start and jumped while punching just to reach the nigga face. But props to Havoc for setting it off. But in all honesty, in a one-on-one head-up fight, Tragedy would have roofed that nigga like a handball. But when dudes told him not to fight back, he chose to take the ass whooping out of fear of getting shot or poked up by one of them Mobb Deep niggas. But anyways, Havoc just started beating the shit out that nigga. And according to Prodigy, this called Nore to get nervous, cause they slightly outnumbered and the midget is beating Franks out his homeboy. And he don't know if the midgets to society is gonna beat up his ankles next. So Nore pulled out a gun and shot at the ground to like break the shit up, right? But the bullet ricocheted off the ground and hit one of the Mobb Deep niggas in the leg. Not Mobb Deep, hit one of their homies in the leg. And niggas scattered and there was beef after that.
The next day, Johnny came through the block on crutches with a cast on his leg. Nore could never show his face in Queensbridge again.
But that was just the first incident. Fast forward to like 2 weeks later, Ty Nitty, who's down with Mobb Deep and was present during the last Planet of the Midgets attack, was in the hood tipsy, and he ran into his ops, Capone, Noriega, and Tragedy. And him and Noriega got into it, exchanged words, and fists was thrown. Ty Nitty claims Nore and Capone tried to jump him, but it was just like a small scuffle, nothing crazy. Nobody really got hurt or took any damage. Aye, so boom. Fast forward another 2 weeks. Mobb Deep crew and CNN are booked for a show at the same club in Queens.
"The only reason we went was so we could catch Nore and torture him for what he did to Johnny."
They know they're going to see each other, so Mobb Deep crew parked their car like in a cut across the street from the club, but like facing the club. That way they can watch the scenery from a distance and get the drop on their ops. And it wasn't long until they spotted Nore, Tragedy, and Capone lacking in the front of the club. So Ty Nitty, the dude they tried to jump like in the last incident, and two other Mobb Deep affiliates get out the car and they approach Nore crew. Ty Nitty was like, "Yo, Nore, let me holler at you." Nore knew it was static, but he probably figured they were just going to talk it out or whatever. But that wiffle head was wrong. He walked off with Ty Nitty, and 6 steps later, that nigga got turned to a ballerina. Ty Nitty hit that nigga with a Dante Wilder combo and had that nigga walking on his tippy toes before dropping.
I said, "Yo, Nore, come in, Nore." And I grabbed him by his hoodie, and I punched him once, and I punched him twice. I knocked him to the floor. He was bleeding.
And that's when Ty Nitty's homies ran over, and together, they beat the Miss Mary Mac, all dressed in black nursery rhymes out that nigga.
Gotti, Havoc, and I stood by the trucks and watched them beat the clothes off of that boy. I never saw somebody get jumped so bad.
While this was going down, Nore crew didn't jump in. They just watched him get the green eggs and hand beat out of him. But this is where versions of the story differ. Prodigy claims after the ass whooping, Nore people went to their car and came back with a Tech 9 machine gun, let off the whole clip at them, and shot Ty Nitty in the back.
Nitty was screaming and bleeding like a pig in my backseat.
Ty Nitty said that's a lie and that he ain't even get shot in the back. He also said Prodigy was hiding under the car when the shots was going off, so he ain't even see what happened.
When I beat Noriega up, Prodigy ran under the trucks. He was hiding under the cars.
Nore claims that after he got jumped, soon as he got up, he started shooting at niggas. So it's up to you though who you believe, but we just gonna dismiss Prodigy account on what happened, cause his shit was sounding like Speaker Knocker's Rico story part 2. It was sounding like a movie. Ty Nitty didn't even get hit in the back.
Whoever had the gun shot Nitty in his back.
See that part right there? That's why I got hit right there, you know? See how something be wild? He said it was a Tech 9. He lying about what I got hit with.
But Nore was claiming that he shot Ty Nitty, and Ty Nitty said it wasn't Nore. But he also said that he was walking away when shots went off.
When I was walking away, that's when shots went off. Shots, gunfire went off. And I got hit in my leg.
So if that's the case, there's a possibility that Nore was letting off shots while Ty Nitty back was turned. And not only that, Nore's on Vlad TV telling stories about shooting at people, telling how he went to jail when he was 14 for shooting somebody. So he got a history of being a shooter. But once again, RP Prodigy, but whose story y'all believe in this scenario?